To Bree. Subject: Bree, please read this. Bree, don't delete this. I know you hate me, but we were best friends in high school, and I need you to read this. I think I'm in serious trouble here, and there's nothing you can do, but I need you to read this so that you understand. I know we haven't talked since sectionals. It's been forever. But what happened to you wasn't my fault. At least, it wasn't entirely my fault. I know everybody thinks it was, but I would never hurt you or do anything to hurt you. This is gonna sound crazy, but I need to tell you this so that somebody knows. It started back when we were in 8th grade. It was the night before the Crystal Classic competition. I was at home and I just couldn't sleep. I was so nervous about competing. Well, I got on the computer and just sort of web surfed and stuff. But I couldn't concentrate on anything, so I was just sitting there. I googled myself. I never should have done that, Bree. At first it was just the normal stuff you find when you google yourself. Then I found a Wikipedia page about me. I thought maybe the club or dad made it or something. There wasn't much there, just some basic facts about skating, what city I lived in. But the thing that got me was it said I won that year's Crystal Classic. I laughed. I thought for sure someone just did it to encourage me. I confronted my dad about it, but he denied it. When I won the competition the next day, I was so happy. That was the first competition I had won and it felt so good. Remember how hard I worked after that? When my parents hired Sergey to coach me, you know how much that must have cost? After that, I would check the page before every competition, and it would always tell me the result of how I placed. It said I won the regionals at 15, and it all came true. After that, Sergey convinced my mom and my dad that I had a real shot at the Olympics. That's when they pulled me out of school. I skate every day, but it just wasn't progressing the way Sergey and I needed to if I wanted a shot at the championship. I was working so hard and I was skating so well, but Sergey still said it wasn't good enough. That's when the sectionals came. All I could think about was winning. So I did something I shouldn't have. Everyone was saying that you were the favorite, and I felt like I had already lost the competition. So I made up a Wikipedia account and tried to update my page to say that I was the winner. The thing is that after I tried to update the page, I checked it and it said, "Honora Petrova is a selfish little bitch and she's gonna get what she deserves." I broke down. That's why I looked so awful that day. I was in a haze. I remember watching your routine, seeing your blade snap, and the next thing I know, I was on the ground. My face was covered in blood from where the tip flew off and sliced into my forehead. They told me that it was my fault that I had your skates in my possession earlier. Bree, I honestly didn't do anything to your skates. I wanted to win, but I would never do anything to hurt you. When they told me I was banned from any further competition, everybody said I got what I deserved. Nobody asked for my side of the story. I guess you heard that Sergey dropped me after that. He said I ruined him. No one would talk to me. Do you know what it's like to be ostracized by everybody? I couldn't even get ice time. And the page got even worse. Anytime I check it, it would say all these awful, horrible things about me. I can't even tell you half of them. The language was so vile I would cry every time I read it. But I couldn't stop checking it. I knew I had to do something, so I made a complaint to Wikipedia. I tried calling them, but no one there claimed to know anything about the page. I was home alone one Friday night and decided to check to see if the page had been taken down. It was still there, only this time it said, "Honora Petrova is a pathetic little orphan." I freaked out. I kept calling my parents to warn them, but every time I would call, there would just be this horrible, awful laughter on the other end. I must have called them 100 times, until I just couldn't take the sound of the laughter anymore. After the accident, the police gave me their cell phones, and there wasn't any record of my calls that night. I was so devastated. Before that, I was so busy training all day and doing homeschool, I never realized just how alone I had been the whole time. I know you try to reach out, but I was so depressed and angry that I just shut everything out. Once I turned 18 and got my settlement money from the court, I moved out to Switzerland. I got the chance to reinvent myself. My skating really took off, and it's been about a year, and I feel like everything that happened was so long ago. And I shouldn't have done it, Bree. I'm writing you now from a hotel outside of Prague. I'm auditioning for the ice circus tomorrow. I know it's the kind of thing we used to make fun of, but I really want this. I was feeling pretty nervous, and out of old habit, I checked my page. It's hard to say this, but when I checked to see if I got the job tomorrow, all it said was, Honora Petrova died, friendless and alone. And it has today's date listed as my date of death. I'm sobbing so hard, I can barely write this. But I wanted you to know the truth. Please believe me, Bree. I attached a screenshot of the page so that you will believe me. It's all there, just as I told you. And I don't know what to do. I don't know anybody out there who speaks English. I just keep refreshing the page. God, it's been forever. I keep refreshing it and nothing's changed. I'm waiting for midnight. I don't know what else to do. So, I locked myself in a room. It's only a few minutes until midnight now. All I can do is just sit here and refresh, refresh, refresh. I'm exhausted, but I can't stop. I'm afraid to leave the computer until I know what happens next. I want to thank all the lovely patrons currently listed on screen right now. Dan R, Neophyte Games, Chaos X, JY Pyromancer, Hayden MH, Ethan A, Daniel H, Maximilian Charles P, Go Go Cute Puppy LLC, Young Sykes, Dark Side of the Bear, Revenick, Paul T, and Mr. Swiston. Guys, thank you all so, so much.